objective of this chapter is to become familiar with the origins of the international agreements on maritime trade, the role of the IMO, the International Maritime Organization, SOLAS 74 and MARPOL 7378. In April 1912, the liner Titanic struck an iceberg and sank. More than 1,500 passengers and crew died. The following year, an international conference was held in London, and in 1914, the first International Convention for the Safety of Life at Sea, or SOLAS, was adopted and signed by representatives of the world's leading maritime nations. It included regulations on navigation, ship construction, life-saving appliances, and emergency communications. One basic problem was that there was no international organization which could coordinate and monitor the measures drawn up by these conventions. An example relevant to this program was that the labels identifying and categorizing dangerous goods differed from country to country. The formation of the United Nations organization provided the opportunity for creating just such a specialized marine agency, and the resulting Intergovernmental Maritime Consultative Organization, or IMCO, came into being in 1959. The new organization drew up a new version of the International Convention for the Safety of Life at Sea, the most important of all treaties dealing with maritime safety, and then turned its attention to the carriage of dangerous goods, producing the first edition of the International Maritime Dangerous Goods Code in 1965. In 1982, the IMCO changed its name to the International Maritime Organization, or, as it is more commonly referred to, the IMO. The IMO is responsible for keeping a number of codes dealing with dangerous goods up to date. These include the IMDG Code, the BC Code, or Code of Safe Practice for Solid Bulk Cargoes, the IBC Code, or International Code for the Construction and Equipment of Ships Carrying Dangerous Chemicals in Bulk, for ships constructed after the 1st of July 1986. The IGC Code, or International Code for the Construction and Equipment of Ships Carrying Liquefied Gases in Bulk, for ships constructed after the 1st of July 1986. The International Convention for the Safety of Life at Sea, 1974, is the current SOLAS Convention, and came into force in 1980. A series of amendments also applies. Chapter 7 of SOLAS 74 covers the carriage of dangerous goods by sea. The International Convention for the Prevention of Pollution from Ships was passed by the IMO in 1973 and modified by the Protocol of 1978. The Convention and the Protocol are known as MARPOL 7378. A series of amendments also applies. Annex 3 of MARPOL 7378 deals with the prevention of pollution by harmful substances carried by sea in packaged form. In 1985, Annex 3 was aligned with the IMDG Code, thereby introducing the implications of marine pollution to the carriage of dangerous goods. The relevant sections in the SOLAS and MARPOL conventions concerned with the carriage of dangerous goods by sea lay down the guidelines, and the IMO, through its committee structure, produces the detailed provisions and codes of practice. The IMDG Code includes a section on training for shore-based personnel. Amendment 3408 made such training mandatory instead of just recommended, and may be audited by the competent authority. Persons who have not been trained may only operate under the direct supervision of a trained person. Training shall be appropriate, planned, and commensurate with responsibility. It shall establish a general understanding of the provisions of the code, job and task-specific competence, and safety awareness and a knowledge of emergency procedures. For personnel on ships carrying dangerous goods, Many of the specific procedures discussed in this program will already have been addressed when a package is loaded on board. However, training in the handling of such cargoes will form part of your company's safety management system and will enhance both operational performance and personal safety. The IMDG Code has a section on security, but we must also refer to the International Ship and Port Facility Security Code, generally referred to as the ISPS Code, for such guidance.